Hi all, this is Sammy with Avid CNC, and this is a pro tip video on how to use the Auto Z and corner finding touch plate with the Avid CNC Mach4 screen set. This tool allows you to quickly and easily find precise settings of your workpiece height, corner, and edge location. It's dual-sided for Z only, X, Y, Z finding. It also has a spring-loaded brass plate safety feature, quick connecting magnet, and corner finding wall. In this video, we'll cover the basics of how to set up your work offset using the Auto Z and corner finding touch plate. Go ahead and turn on your CNC controller. Once your controller is on and connected to your PC, open Mach4. The first thing we'll do is home or machine. Click home XYZ. This will send signals to move the machine in each direction and trip the sensors at the end of each axis. This will establish the limit of machine travel, reset the machine zero, and ensure that both sides of the gantry are aligned. Once we've homed, we want to give our machine what's called work offsets from the machine coordinates that move the G-code program origin, or our zero, so we can locate our project in a more convenient location. Let's establish a fundamental understanding of machine coordinates and work offsets. When we click Home XYZ, this allows the machine to find its machine coordinates or the limits of the machine. Often, this is the front left corner. This allows the machine to understand its work envelope represented in green. I like to think of this as the machine waking up in the morning. It's a little sleepy and needs to search around for its glasses on the bedside table so we can figure out where it is in space. Now, we need to give the machine offsets from those machine coordinates to tell the machine where the material is located in relation to the machine coordinates. This is understood by the controller as XYZ offsets. We can think of this as the starting point from which to run our G-code. One of the simplest ways to set your zero or your workpiece coordinates is to choose a corner or reference point on our workpiece. We have a few options here which might be influenced by your material type, shape, and toolpath operation selections. So when we run our G-code, the work offset, also known as our zero, will be our starting point. This is like the starting point on a map, and the toolpath is the route on the map for the machine to follow. The G-code is like the instructions on how to follow that path written in a language that the machine can understand. The code includes how far, how fast, and in which direction to move from that starting point, similar to following a route on a map. We have to set our zero twice, once in our G-code exported by our CAM program, and once when we're setting up our project on the machine and in the controller program. If we give the machine the incorrect starting point on the machine that doesn't match the selected corner in our CAM program, this is similar to giving a friend a map but placing them at the wrong trailhead. They just won't get to where they want to go. So ensure that you have selected the same corner in your CAM program and as your setup on the machine. We recommend you use a 10-step cycle start checklist every time you're ready to run a program. We've linked a video to this in the description below. In the VCarve initial file setup, we can select our zeroing point. For our Z-axis, we can select the material surface or the machine bed. For our XY location, we can choose any of the four corners of our workpiece. You can rotate the touch plate so the corner wall snugly fits on your selected corner. I'll use the front left corner. In Mach4, let's double check that our touch plate is operating properly. To confirm that the touch plate is able to form a complete circuit, touch the magnet to the brass plate. On the Mach4 screen, the probe signal will light up as active. You can also place the magnet on the router bit and then lift the touch plate to touch the router bit. If the probe signal lights up as active, then you're ready to go. Let's go ahead and set our zero to the front left corner and surface of our material. Confirm that this is the same corner you've selected in your CAM program. Go ahead and open the Auto Z and corner finding touch plate window. Enter the diameter of the router bit you're going to use to set your work offset. We have 9 options corresponding to the touch plate zeroing operations. When you hover your cursor over a button, it will display a box explaining what that operation will do. I'll place the touchplate on the corner of our material, and then drive the spindle over the touchplate so the bit is about centered and 1 inch from the brass plate. Then attach the magnet to the router bit. Click the corresponding image on the zeroing window. I'll select the bottom left corner. The bit will lower until it contacts the brass plate. This will complete the circuit, sending a signal to the machine, allowing the program to calculate the distance the bit is from the material surface. The bit will then lift up, and Mach4 will prompt us to rotate the bit so the cutting edge of the flute touches the Y wall. Then click OK. The bit will move back to contact the Y wall. Then Mach4 will prompt us to rotate the bit again 90 degrees to contact the right X wall. Go ahead and click OK. We have now set our zero to the front, left, and top corner of the material. Also take note, when you load your G-code into Mach4, if you use the Avid CNC post processor version 1.3 or later, the Z origin and XY origin will also be listed here in your G-code. This is a great way to double check your XYZ0 after you've already exported your toolpaths from your CAM program. Let's talk a little bit about router bit selection in relation to the touchplate. Starting with an end mill, you can set your X, Y, and Z0, though we should be conscious of the flute in relation to the walls of the touchplate. Our goal is for the widest point or the cutting edge of the flute to contact the X and Y walls. Alternatively, you can use a metal dowel to find X and Y. This will give us an accurate reading of the X and Y home, though you will have to re-zero the Z-axis when you switch out your bit. Now there are a few bits we can only use with the Z-axis side of the touchplate. Due to the angle and profile of a V-bit, we can't get the reading of X and Y, though you can use the Z-axis side of the touchplate to set the Z offset. Let's switch out our end mill for a V-bit. You can set your Z0 to the workpiece surface or the spoil board. If there is a variation in the height of your material, you can set your zero to the area you'll be machining. Place the touchplate on the surface you've selected. You can also move the touchplate to the spindle rather than moving the spindle to the touchplate. Attach the magnet, then click the center Z-only icon to initiate the Z probe. Now our Z0 is set to the workpiece surface. We'll do the same operation to set the Z offset for every manual bit change. If you have multiple tools in one setup, you'll only need to set your X and Y offset one time. When you change out a bit, only zero the Z offset. For a walkthrough on how to perform manual tool changes, check out the video linked below. That's it for how to use the Auto Z and Corner Finding Touchplate in Mach4. Thanks y'all for watching, I can't wait to see what you make, and I'll see you in the shop!